The cell. A cell is the smallest structural biological unit that can survive on its own. All plants and animals are composed of one or more cells. Bacteria and algae are examples of complete organisms composed of a single cell, and hence unicellular. At the other end of the spectrum are multicellular organisms, such as animals, composed of billions of cells assembled together into tissues and organs. Cells do not have a uniform shape or size. Some are thin, flat, and circular, while others are cube-shaped. A single cell can be so tiny that it would only be visible without a microscope if thousands of them were clustered together. While in contrast, another cell can be the size of a tennis ball, although the average human cell is barely visible without a microscope. Living organisms are divided into two major groups: prokaryotes, which have a single category comprised of only bacteria, and eukaryotes, which include animals, plants, fungi, and unicellular organisms such as algae and yeasts. Although the structures of prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells are somewhat different, both are composed of similar molecules and act in similar ways. In order to survive, all cells must be in some type of liquid medium, which supplies the cell with food and removes waste. In multicellular organisms, the medium is part of the organism itself, such as sap in a pine tree or blood in the human body. Unicellular organisms, however, need to be in an external body of water, such as a lake or river. The cell is a very efficient organism, although it is susceptible to disease. A cell is a mass of living substance called protoplasm, surrounded by a membrane. Protoplasm, having the consistency of jelly, is composed of water, proteins, and other molecules. Much of the cell's activity occurs in cytoplasm, which is protoplasm located in the main body of the cell. The cytoplasm is where the cell converts molecules of food into energy and manufactures substances needed for development and repair. The cell's membrane, composed of molecules and proteins, allows some, but not all, substances to pass between the cell and the medium. In most prokaryotic cells, and in the eukaryotic cells like those in plants, fungi, and some algae, a rigid cell wall surrounds the membrane, helping the cell to maintain its shape and making it possible for plants to grow vertically. Both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells contain genetic DNA material, although in different forms. In prokaryotes, single-stranded circular DNA floats inside the cell. Prokaryotes employ several means of reproduction. In a simple fission process, the cell replicates its DNA and then divides. Another way prokaryotes can reproduce is through conjugation, a form of simple sexual reproduction involving male and female cells. In contrast to the prokaryotic cell, the DNA in a eukaryotic cell is double-stranded, linear, and enclosed in the cell's nucleus, located near the center of the cell. Eukaryotic reproduction involves one of two processes, mitosis or meiosis. In mitosis, the more common method used by all cells except the germ, sex cells, the two strands, or chromatin, of the DNA wrap around each other several times, producing thicker structures called chromosomes. Each chromosome then makes an identical copy of itself, creating paired chromosomes that form a line in the middle of the cell. Eventually, the pairs split, moving to opposite ends of the cell so that when the cell subsequently divides into two daughter cells, each one has a complete matching set of chromosomes. For humans, this means that each cell will have 46 chromosomes. The two-step process of meiosis, unique to germ cells, produces gametes, which in humans are sperm and eggs. The first step is similar to mitosis, in that the DNA chromosomes duplicate themselves, after which the cell divides. During the second division process that follows, the cells produce four gametes, but this time do not duplicate themselves, leaving each gamete with only half the number of chromosomes compared to the original germ cell. A human sperm and a human egg, for instance, each contain only 23 chromosomes, so that the combination of a male gamete with a female gamete is necessary to reach the full number of chromosomes. When these two gametes fuse, they form a new cell, called a zygote, that is the start of a new organism.